Okay, so yeah, should be live now, hopefully. So, yeah, gonna be continuing Dead Cells, so. The Discord bot just notified me for the upload of the last one, since that, just happened. Pretty much. So, yeah, I played some Dead Cells earlier on my other Switch, so, kind of warm up. So, I guess we'll see how this goes. I won't be able to play for as long as I did yesterday, but I should still be able to play for quite a while. Something I learned earlier is that you can actually, Spartan kick the bombs that those guys throw. Chest here. We got a ice bow to the little star. It's a special ability. So yeah, I think that's not anything there. Just a cell door to look at. I actually ran into one earlier today, so. I don't know. There we go. I was going to say, is that thing going to let me pick it up or no? But it did, so that's good. Trying to go for a few kills here just to get that door, although I don't really have that much time to spare for the second door. So we're gonna go for HP first, then damage. Oh, it looks like that one girl is dead. She's dead, and it's recent. Oh, look what I found. So we got a blueprint for a broadsword. Yeah, we actually didn't get hit there, so I'm wondering if I got enough for the bonus or not. Hoping that I did. No, I didn't get enough kills. But yeah, I had to go through that door pretty soon, because as you can see, the time was almost out, so that's why I was trying to hurry through it. Oh, I actually got a blueprint out of this room for once. So, I think I'm gonna go for the amulet. Assault shield and the broadsword as options. But first, gotta get that health flask up to level 3. One mutation, we'll go for vengeance. It just works our way up. Don't need that. Wonder if I could do this whole run damageless or something. That'd be interesting. Like day 2. I swear I had a terrain duration similar to this earlier. Oh, I've got that little thing where I can jump multiple times. I didn't know that. Looks like I've only got one additional jump. Earlier I had 2. it continues on from what I've already done. I don't actually know where to get keys from anyways. So yeah, if this doesn't have anything at the end of this, then I've played on this before, this generation. I guess we got one door. If it works like how I think it does. I didn't get the assault shield, which is interesting. Oh dang, it's even. .330 and .330. The firebrand's not really worth it, so rather replace the infantry grenade. Or I don't remember that being there, but it could have been. Control through that, but obviously. Okay, it's not a fun one. Oh, it's this thing. I say, like, I cannot do anything to this man. It's that little crystal at the top. Doing so much damage. Get an extra jump. Thing. Mm-hmm. So I'll definitely take that. Lightning bolt. Burn when you run for 3 seconds. Or. I'm just gonna trigger my thing. I'd rather have the other one, honestly. So yeah, I actually got this weapon earlier, so it's not gonna know how it works. Doesn't stun enemies. I tried to do that. Does do a lot of damage per second. Go for the red item. This, gonna go for tactics, and the next time I'll do green. I didn't realize that green wasn't what I was supposed to choose there. Or I mean for optimal HP, I should have chosen it. Not necessarily had to choose it. Not fall on the spikes. These little things here are annoying. Out like I thought, so. Should be able to get a few more cells from the door as well. The one on the left, not the one on the right. I did good damage there. Yep. I was cutting it pretty close, so. I certainly like the wolf trap things. Got an extra health flask, fire grenades as well. Yeah, this is the usual loadout that I've been doing, if possible, with ice grenade, fire grenade. Ice grenade can freeze them, so that way you get in a lot of hits, and then fire grenade's just good for camping. Maybe I should put up a like live sweat timer as well on runs, potentially, just to see how much like actual time it is, not just in-game time. I jumped into that one. Better do it early on, I guess. But I have the whip, so I don't really have to get close to them. Go down here. Maybe I can burn it. No, I didn't do anything. Okay, so go down here. Probably not anything this way, but there are some cells, so that's good. That was kind of good. Okay, so green, so grab this. Oof, no. Oh, that ruined my streak. It would have been a 60 streak as well. That guy also would have ruined it, so. It's that stray arrow. I thought that the guy with the horns would ruin it if anyone. Okay, so. Do I want to replace a 5 on the special ability with a 4? That one? Nope. So now on to Black Bridge. So yeah, I think I'm doing pretty decent so far with those rooms. Okay, so go ahead, do that, then go here. Plus. So, HP restored, and now on to the concierge. I was doing pretty good for damage. There's no way I was gonna do full damageless. Not with this experience boss. But that actually works. I mean, it was a good shot or anything like that. But yeah. And the second attack, like that one there, always throws me. I took very little damage when I wasn't damageless. for the Impaler. And they're basically the same thing, except that the Firebomb works better. The one that I have works better with the electric attack, so. And I'm using two electric weapons. So yeah, that one's better. God, this one's better than what I've got, barely. So yeah, I think I'll go with this Ruby. This one's better than the one that I already have. Sure. So, we get two extra mid-air jumps. Not gonna work on the Forge yet. Just gonna work on the Collector. That'll help at the beginning of runs. I don't see how you can use some of these electric ones, like they're just so good most of the time. Especially in areas with water, but. Is the bit rate fine? Because it looks not so fine. Whenever I was in the blacksmith, it did not look good. Did it just stop working? Or is it just a bit of a glitch? Might just be a bit of a glitch. I'm gonna wait on this menu for a second to see if it goes down. But if it doesn't, then I will be right back or something. So I just wanna see if it's actually working or if it's like glitching out a bunch or what's happening. Alright, I should probably walk around for a second, and that'll help. So, the stream replay is a bit behind. I'm gonna, like, roll around a bit just to see if that does anything, and then refresh the page. I just don't want it to be dropping a bunch of frames or anything. I mean, yeah, it looked fine, so. Anyway, I just wanted to make sure that, that was good, because I'm not going to be doing too many runs. It was probably just a random spike, I guess. You can also pick those, just pretty much any explosive with those for Saddleback and the Pirate Captain guy. That's 1/3 of my pollution gone. Thank you. Okay, so... Love her Spartan sandals. They're a lighter berry. As I said earlier, you can use them to, you could make that drink before, I guess you can. You can use them to kick bombs back, which is really useful for this area. Okay. I do want to exit this way, just let me get those enemies in there. It's just the spark kick is kind of slow, I guess. Want to see if you can get like above that? Spartan kick, but whatever. Okay, so grab this. Slowly getting some more HP. Did it. I believe. Until I reach the end. I'll go back and do this, and what I'm doing now is it. Worth it a bit because I got some HP back in case the exit's not anywhere nearby. Except you know it's right there, which is fine, I guess. So now we're on to Clock Tower. So instead, he wins the race. Broadsword, since that's just an easy slot. You have to get a lot of slots to be able to get more upgrades and stuff, because some of them are locked behind a certain number of upgrades. Some villagers claim to have seen the hands of the pod turning backwards. Of course, those are just rumors. That portal on the right active. Cells, it looks like, yep. Might as well get topped off with the health. Okay, so... Oh, actually, I managed to take that guy mid attack. Okay, so I almost got stabbed there by the hooded guys. Spartan sandals. Is that actually worth it at all? This combination. have. Yeah, the other one's just better. Pretty much every way. Okay, so I actually need to go here, I think. Yeah, that should be the right path. The clock tower boss. Clockmaker. Not really a reason to drink that, I just kinda did. Is there anything like around 30? Maybe the grenades? Because always need more grenades, you know? I think I've got 30 seconds to beat this guy, so. Maybe I've got a bonus. I don't really remember the timing. But the timekeeper. 2, 3. Took about 40 seconds or so. And they're just looting. Sell that. Oh, I don't know, maybe it's like 30 minutes for it, not 25, like I'm thinking. I wonder what took so long. There's just not one there. There's a blacksmith furnace, though. So, I need to unlock 10 more items. For those ones, I only need 5, so. Maybe I should go for melee weapons, since I'm going to be getting a random one at the beginning of every game. Make a bit of sense. HP restored, now on High Peak Castle, which I have yet to make it all the way through this one, so perhaps this is the one. High Peak has fallen from its former glory. The last banquet held here served up human flesh. Don't really have a good loadout for this area, but I think it should be fine. None of those are worth it. Go down. Okay, somehow that guy just decided to be able to be hitting. Blueprint. Okay, now I have to make it through here, so I have to play extra cautious. Time is no longer of the essence. The only thing that matters now is surviving. Okay, well. take back damage from him, I guess. So I haven't gone to this door. He hit me from 50,000 feet away. There is nothing I could do. Guy had more range than my lightning whip, which has like infinite range. Let's see, what am I gonna get this time? If it's a nutcracker, then there's something going wrong. Okay, so it is the Spartan sandals for the melee weapon that I start with, so that's gonna be fun. Not the best starting weapon, let's say. Yeah, if it would have been the Nutcracker, that was the weapon that I got on the playthrough after. Like, whenever I saved, I went and saw what weapon I got. I only switched and it was the Nutcracker, so I thought there might be some sort of connection in the RNG. Because I just transferred save data over just so that way I didn't have to start from the beginning of the other switch. Well, Spartan Sandal is fun, it's also pretty fun to just, you know, just, you know. Sure, it's convenient finding all these messages on the walls. Lore on a shoestring. Writing is fairly legible. Don't want contaminated. out of here. See you again, I hope. The malaise. Not infected. Die. Oh, I still thought I had the Spartan sandals. It's like a charge attack. Oh, there is. Okay. So you just line up somebody and do a charge attack and then just take some out. Okay, so, yeah. Hold on 1 second, I need to check this message here. Something. Okay, so I need to look something up real fast, and then I'll be back. Okay, so what does this person look like? Images. So hopefully that's correct on that. But yeah, just in this quiz thing, happens at 2. Okay, it looks like... Well, that's not fixing anything. What will fix things? Doing that. Okay. So yeah, it looks like this run's ending early, because... yeah, that just means that the capture card's messing up. I literally don't know why it's just doing that, but whatever. So yeah, if I keep it on, then it's gonna mess up. If you want to hear the audio mess up, you can hear me trying to fix it, but yeah, I will probably be back tomorrow, hopefully, with another run, because I think I might try to do one or two runs a week, just recorded. So yeah, I might finish this one later, just so that way I can get it recorded and stuff. But yeah, I did get the person right, so that's good. It was Motoyasu from Rising of the Shield Hero. If you're wondering what it was, it's like this character quiz where this person uploads a image of a kind of voxel form of a character to guess who it is. So, yeah, that's what I was doing. But yeah, I will be hopefully back tomorrow with another run recorded. Or like the ending of this run, probably. I'll just go ahead and finish it out on a recording once I get the capture card fixed. So, yeah, I guess we'll see everyone in the next one.